Hey guys, DNSMA here. I got bored and I was looking through some of my collected stuff. You guys know I build models, I collect things, I work with my hands a lot. Very crafty, I guess you could say. Skilled with my hands. A lot of things I can do with my hands. Carpentry, automotive, model building. Which, since we're talking about small items, again, yes, I do build models. These are some model engines that I was working on. I did a video about these before on a Civic engine. It's hard to see any of this stuff because it's just so small, you know, and this phone is not, doesn't have a magnifier. I could get the kit, I guess. I don't know. But anyways, but I wanted to show you this. It's a little bit of a collection that I had, and I've been wanting to make a video about this, but this is just some random Hot Wheels stuff, and I'm a big Hot Wheels collector. I like them in the package and as pristine as possible. Kind of rare Hot Wheels stuff that you don't see very often. Not stuff that you're really used to. I do have some other mixed up stuff here that I want to collect for just different reasons. But most of it is 90% Hot Wheels. This is just from Attack of the Clones, which is a while back. I wanted R2-D2 and C-3PO. I just wanted them both. C-3PO, this is the protocol droid that Anakin built. Where he didn't have shielding at first, and then it's with removable panels, which I'd never seen that before for C-3PO and all, so I thought that was pretty cool. And then the R2-D2. Now, you know how long ago Attack of the Clones came out, okay? And check this out. It's still in the package. It's not been opened. Everything, I like it. It's got some dents in it, which I don't like, because the backs of these things need to be like baseball cards. They can't be bent. They can't have a crease in them. They can't have marks on them, or it devalues them. But what I wanted to show you guys is that after all this time, it still works. The battery is still good in this thing, which is amazing to me. All right, but anyway, so that's just that one little thing there. But there's just some other little things. I'm not going to go through all of this really quick. This is not going to be a really long video. I've been doing a lot of work today, so I was digging around through some of the stuff. So my hands are a little dirty, I know. There's a lot of dust on this stuff, on these little containers. The lids are just dusty as hell, because, I mean, we're talking almost 20 years old stuff here, at least. But there's just some odd stuff, rare stuff, things you just don't see very often. Here's an old matchbox for the Florida Marlins. Oh, no. This is the Florida Panthers. When the Panthers first came out, back in, was it 97? 90. It's a limited edition. I can't remember what year this was. Oh, 93. That's it. 1993. And but it's never been opened. It's still in the package. It's for the Florida Panthers when they pretty much, I guess, when they first came out, I guess, or something. I got some 2006 is mixed in here. There's some stuff that I wanted because this was a 1970 Dodge Challenger. And I thought that was pretty cool, and I just wanted it because they had the shaker hood, and so I wanted that. But anyways, then I had I got like the Austin Powers Shagmobile, you know, and that was a Johnny Lightning thing. But I just kind of thought, well, what the hell, you know. But I've also got some other stuff in here, like a TV guide, 25 top cult shows ever. Now, this particular TV guide was a little bit different because, and as you can see, there's nothing printed here. You usually would get these in the mail, and you'd have your TV guide. I don't know if anyone remembers this or not, but that's what it was. And, you know, it would just give you your channel lineups. Like, now, everything is digital, and it's right there in your cable box, but, you know, and it looks identical to your cable box. So, that's what they based it all off of. But there was extra stuff, like Sudoku and crossword puzzles and all kinds of other stuff and advertisements and little articles and stuff that you could look at. And that was just kind of neat. I don't know. There's something about that because I like Star Trek and stuff like that. These were stuff that came in cereal boxes, and this was mounted to the cereal box from the inside, so you would actually see what the car was that you were going to get. And this was a Dodge NASCAR from, I don't remember what cereal box this was from, maybe Cheerios or something like that. But that's what that was. And then, of course, there's some other stuff. Now, in here, on the bottom of this particular one, I have to stack these the way that they stack them. Well, this isn't really the way they stack them from the factory and the boxes, the way they came. But these are the old Hot Wheels containers that you would store all your loose Hot Wheels in back in the day. Okay. Oh, look, here's the Sam Walton Walmart truck. And he's even got his little dog. You can't hardly see it, but he's got his little dog in his little dog cage. How the fuck can I... Right in the back. And that was Sam Walton's truck that he drove all the way up until the day he died. I'm pretty sure that's what they said. But he just kept that old 79 Ford. I'm a big Ford fan. I like Chevys because I get to work on them a lot. It makes me money. I don't get to work on Fords too often. So they don't make me too much money. Now this here, I'm going to move on to the next box here. I'm not going to really get into all the loose Hot Wheels. I'll make another video because I want to make this short. This is... The date on this is September 12th, 2001. Because on September 11th, and this is the Miami Herald, okay? Or the Herald for Broward. And this was what happened right after. This was the newspaper, and it's in pristine shape. I haven't even opened it really, but it's the pristine shape of Bush vows revenge for attacks on 9/11. And you know, you can see there's all kinds of stuff in here, but I collected that because I thought that was just a piece of history that just needed to be collected. And I did. I kept it, and it's still here. So this is from 2012, Wednesday, September 12th, 2001, final edition. And it was what Bush fouled. And then, of course, I had to collect this to kind of follow up on that. Okay. So, and this, of course, was May 2nd, 2011. So 10 years after it happens, or 9 years after it happens. No, 10 years. 10 years. Wait, 10 or 11? What did I say? Yeah, 10 years after it happened. Almost whatever. We finally get them. Now this is my favorite box right here because this is the year 2000 collection. The complete year 2000 collection. And I've even got the box here to. Or the little book here that shows you all of the cars that were in the year 2000 collection, so you knew to get them all. And so this whole box is dedicated to just that. I've got some other stuff in here a little bit, just because it didn't take this whole box to fill it up. But I'm talking about, you guys remember those wheels? I mean, before we had the Red Line. I mean, after the Red Line came this style wheel. Well, actually, that style wheel. And then, not long after, came that style wheel. So this has both styles wheels on it, which is why I wanted it. Plus, it's just an old one. It's one of the old, I'm not sure what year it is. But the yellow has turned, or the plastic has turned yellow and stuff like that. So this is technically the way that Hot Wheels likes to package up their vehicles. Is they stack them like that, upside down, right side up, upside down, right side up. And yada yada, but yeah, this box contains the entire year 2000 collection, along with some knockoffs. I mean, not knockoffs, but some oddball ones that I found. Like for instance, this one here. This was a Hot Wheels that was exclusively for Avon. Okay, so you couldn't get this in the store. As you can see, it doesn't even have a cutout to hang it like all the others do. It doesn't have any kind of a hangout. Of a hanger. It was never meant to be in a store, and there's no push out, there's nothing. It's a father and son collector pack. And this was just for Avon. That's it. You couldn't get this. This was basically a Mercedes and, well, two Mercedes, just an older one and a newer one. And these were just ones we were already familiar with, but they were very specific colors. And the packaging is not that great. It's a little torn up a little bit. It's not the best, but it's still in the package and all of that. So anyway, I just thought that was kind of neat. So, and then of course I've got my Red Lines that I need to restore. I've got a collection of those. Hey, you guys remember these? Oh man, you gotta remember this. Because I couldn't find these anywhere. I mean, well, I could, but do you guys remember these back in the day? You remember this one? There was a couple of them. There was a red one that had a top that would flip over and it would look like it was crushed. And then there's one that had sides that would flip over and look like it's crushed. But what you did is with these is you ran them into a corner, and then it would go like that. It would go boom, and it looked like it's crushed. It looks like you just wrecked it, like you hit a pole or something. And then all you did was you just flipped it back over and snapped the hood down, and it looked back to factory again. Which I thought was just really cool, because then you're just like, bam, you're running into something, and it's like, they were like crashers, I think they were called. And it just really made the car look like it was crashed. But it was just a spring-loaded, and this still works, a spring-loaded little thing there. Do you remember these things, guys? I don't know. Anyways. So, then I went into getting some other stuff that was... It had nothing to do with Hot Wheels, but I just liked them because the whole import tuner thing was popping at that time, and that was really cool. Now, some of these I do have in protective. Now, okay, this one, I've got some, they're called, God, what are they called? They're called, well, there's a lot of value when it comes to these as collectors. If you can find mismarks where they've marked it wrong, such as this one. They're saying that this is the X-Way Cruiser series, and this is supposed to be a Mercedes C-Class, and it's not. It's Dogfighter. And they put it in the wrong package. So it's been mismarked. It's been mislabeled. So it's kind of like stamp collecting. It's the same thing. If they mismark, if you find one that's mislabeled or whatnot, I really like this one. And so these are protective covers that you can buy, just like for baseball cards, but it's for Hot Wheels. And you can buy these fairly cheaply, to protect. It's just an investment for your protection for your investment is all it is. Insurance, accessionally. What am I trying to say? See, now I got another Mercedes C-Class here that was mismarked. So these are two mismarks in a row. These are supposed to be Mercedes C-Classes, and they're not. They're actually called Dogfighter. That's the name of that car. Now, and then of course Dub Cities came out. And, well, you guys remember these things, Beach Blaster, back in the day, man, with those kind of Hot Wheels? That's the Hot Wheels I grew up with, man. It was those kind of wheels, you know? You had the one with the Incredible Hulk where you could look through the back of it, and there was a lens, and you could actually see, like, a scene from one of the cartoon series of Incredible Hulk or Captain America or all kinds of cool stuff. But I think those had the raised top to it or something like that. I don't know. I don't remember. Anyways, so then I had like, you know, I got into like 95 Acuras and stuff like that. They were little tuners, and they had the little exhaust tips and the clear taillights and the, you know, back in the 2000 era crap. Got the original rigger motor. It's in that protective thing too, and it's getting a little yellowish too, but that's the original rigger motor. I actually cut the skulls off of this. Off of one of these and used them on a model a long time ago as like a gear shift knob, and I thought that was pretty cool. And then a lot of this stuff is just, again, now this is what's called a treasure hunt. Okay, now this is the reason that these treasure hunts are worth $50 right off the bat. Every Hot Wheels is like worth about a dollar, you know what I mean? You can buy it for about a dollar, but you can actually go into a Walmart, and if you can find a treasure hunt. Let's see if I can get this. This is a treasure hunt series Roger Dodger. Okay? And, you know, they got rubber wheels. They're done up extra special nice. And they are strictly for collectors. They're worth $50 right off the bat. You can buy it from Walmart, put it on eBay, get 50 bucks for it right off the bat. So it keeps guys, like, waiting around at Walmart for them to... Like, there are people that actually wait at Walmart and have inside scoops. Here's another treasure hunt. This is Roll Cage. Again, rubber wheels. A lot of them had gold rims and or gold accessory. Like this one has a gold engine and some gold. Well, that's it. Gold engine and gold floorboard, looks like. And but it's got rubber wheels. It's got a plastic spare wheel, but it's got rubber actual wheels. So, which is kind of weird. But I mean, just little things like that. I've got a bunch of different treasure hunts, and I always put them in those protective covers, these little protective covers, so you can still hang them. And then eventually what I want to do is just hang all of these on the wall like it's a toy store or something like that, you know. I have my hobby room, and have all of that kick in and all that. But I mean, there's just so many in here. Now here's another Roger Dodger. Or was that the same one? I think that's the same one. Alright. But anyways, look, check this one out. Isn't that, remember this one, guys? Remember playing with Blazer? 4x4? I think the hood opens on this one. No, never mind. I don't know, man. There's just so many in here that I wish I could just go through and just pull them all out and show them all to you. And show you some of the older stuff that I've got, some of the newer stuff, some of the 20-year-old stuff, 30-year-old stuff, 40-year-old stuff, and all of that. But I'm going to go ahead and just cut this video short because it's already 15 minutes long. But this is a little collection of my Hot Wheels, and they're deep. I mean, they're not like shallow bins. They're actually pretty deep, and they're all pretty stacked in there pretty well. They're stacked pretty freaking well. There's more, but I just don't have any with me at this moment. I have to go and get them out of storage and stuff, but these are the ones that I really, really care about. And like I said, these right here are the ones that I want to restore. I've been watching a lot of videos on them, on how to restore them. I'm not sure if I should. I know I want to restore this Ferrari, because this is a redline Ferrari from the original lineup of the Hot Wheels series. It's missing the back cover, the back hood, or bonnet, whatever you want to call it. But this was that, like, formula style, old school, one-seater race car, mid-engine. And this is a Porsche. This is an actual, this is the Hot Wheels, shit, I can't read that. Anyways, but I need to restore all these and get them back into shape. This was the, I forget the name of this one. This was it's a dragster, a funny car, but it would lift up. And this was back in the 60s they had this thing. So this was like really revolutionary back then, where you could actually pop the hood on a funny car and check out the engine and the roll cage and stuff like that. And that was just amazing back then. That was real, and it's still cool to this day. But what's funny is that they only put, wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, my bad. I was looking at the white lines instead of the other ones. I was going to say, it looked like it had a V6 in it, and I'm like, what? There's no dragster with a V6, and then I'm like, oh wait, no, that is a V8. Got four exhaust pipes, all right, good. But anyway, so that was just something I figured I'd give you guys a quick tour and get a little feedback. And I do have a lot of, oh, where did that one go? I've got another one. Oh, where did that one go? Where I've got all the... When Star Wars came back out. When George Lucas came back out with Star Wars. That's when I bought those. But there's also some other stuff. And I'm trying to find it. Where did I put it? Maybe it isn't... No, I've got another one of these boxes somewhere. And it's got a bunch of those... I collected like all of the McDonald's Happy Meal toys that went with it. Oh, this one's pretty cool. I got a lot of these collector things too. This is the Moonies. Or Moon Eyes. Collection. It's the Moon Eyes equipped with the truck and the little car carrier truck. And then I've got like the Willys Gassers ones, and then which are like, it has its own little diorama where they're like popping wheelies as they take off at the drag strip and shit. And just so many cool things. I like the Mercedes, I mean the motorcycles. I like all the Ferraris. Those are actually my favorite of all the Hot Wheels are the Ferraris. Here's a Porsche. James Dean Porsche. Oh, I'm sorry, it's a Jaguar, my bad. I thought this was the James Dean Porsche. No, it's a Jaguar, yeah. But it includes these include display cases. So you just take them out, you set them up, and it says what they are, and you can just put them on a shelf, and it's pretty awesome. Rubber wheels, a lot of detail. Let's see here, what is this one? This one is an A2 Corvette Stingray. What is this one? Oh, here's the Marlins one. Imagine, I thought I had the Marlins one. I knew I had the Marlins one. So I have the Panthers from 93, and I got the Marlins. So, yeah. So those are from there. And here's another. These are 2006 model, new models, and it's a 1970 Challenger, which I thought was awesome. What is this one? I think this is an import one. Yeah. This is the Hot Wheels Super Street, which is I think this was a Honda Civic hatchback and a Honda Civic just straight up sedan. and or coupe, I mean, Honda Civic coupe, and then a Honda Civic hatchback. No, sedan, because wait a minute, the coupe has two doors. Yeah, that's what it is. Yeah, the coupe has two doors, sedan has four. So, anyways, this is just a quick nostalgia video. You nostalgia lose. The toys that we just never got tired of playing with. And here I am, a grown-ass man, and I'm still collecting the toys that I had when I was a kid. It's just, you know, for the girls out there, it's that easy bake oven nostalgia. It's that, there's reasons that we do this. That we, ooh, I don't want to bend that, so I'm going to put that over here. But I like this one because it has a drag, it has the light tree. It's a charger? What is this? Is it a charger? I want to say it's a charger. No, it's a Mustang Fastback. But I got it because it was a funny car, and it had the tree on it. So I figured maybe if I did a diorama one day. It's a Johnny Lightning. I don't really like Johnny Lightnings that much. They don't have a whole lot of value. But some cars, they do. I'm a Hot Wheels fan. Anyways, guys, I'll let this go. It's already 20 minutes now. Shit, 21 minutes. But anyways, if you have any questions or comments, if you want to see the rest of this collection, maybe I'll lay it all out. Grab, I don't know, a couple thousand thumbtacks and stick them up on the wall. You know, I'm not going to actually put the thumbtack through any of these. I'll just let it hang on the hanger. But I think that would be cool to just lay all of these on the wall. I mean, just basically wallpaper the wall with all brand new Hot Wheels that are still in the package and just have them divided into sections with maybe some labels. And so I thought that would be really cool for like a hobby room. And then the open ones, and I have a little hobby desk there so I can do some restoration and model building and things like that. But I'm just still amazed because I really did believe that this was not going to work. He's got a different... I don't know if you can hear that, but... Anyways, alright guys, it's been a while since I've uploaded a video. I just figured I'd do it. Upload something. It's kind of bored, just going through, straightening out some stuff. And I saw these, and I'm like, yeah, I've never done a video on these. So I've kind of threatened to make a video on these, but I never did. So here it is. My little stupid Hot Wheels collection. It's 20, 30, 40 years old. I don't know what it's worth, but... I don't know what the year 2000 collection is worth. To have the complete year 2000 collection, with variances, stuff that I got in Canada, stuff that was in the year 2000 collection that, or like the Di Tommaso, I've got like two or three different versions of those. They were all still in the year 2000 version. I don't know, you guys, let me know if anyone can figure out or find out what those are worth. Let me know. I mean, I could probably figure it out on my own, but it'd be just, you know, if you want to find out something easy, just say it wrong on the internet and you'll get a million corrections immediately. But yeah, I mean, there's a lot in here that is just, it really needs to be gone through again. I mean, it's been probably 15, 20 years since I've really pulled everything out of these boxes. A good 15, 20 years. And like I said, I've got more that has like these little Anakin cup, like goes over a cup and then you can sip out of it. There's like all these stupid Star Wars Happy Meal things. When Star Wars first came back out again, of course, McDonald's had all the toys to go with it. So I collected all those just because. And I even have a collection of the Hot Wheels from McDonald's, which were all plastic, really cheaply made because it's McDonald's. I mean, they're giving it away. But did you know that McDonald's is the single most world's largest toy distributor in the world? Well, that's kind of a pretend of a, it's... The world's largest toy distributor is McDonald's. Did you know that?
I didn't know that.
It's true. All their Happy Meal toys, because of the Happy Meal, they actually market and retail more toys than anybody else. That's crazy. So anyways, I got those. Nobody keeps them because they're so cheap, but I did. And so I kept a bunch of those. I've got a ton of these Hot Wheels cars that are from McDonald's in here and that are, because they come loose in the package almost. Almost. I mean, they don't come in packages like this, so you kind of just have to deal with it. It's a little packet like that other one I showed you that was from a cereal box, sort of. It was probably, it was usually in like little packages rip open. But anyways. So I've got all that. If you guys want to see a little more of my collectible stuff, give me a comment, give me a like, subscribe, whatever you want to do. Anyways, all right. Well, that's it. Talk to you later.